Passionate Living with Kat Miller is brought to you by Healthy Communities 2030. For more information, go to creatinghealthycommunities.org.
Welcome to this episode of Passionate Living. I'm Kat Miller, and it's my hope that the amazing people that we meet each week who are living their dreams and making a difference in the world around them will inspire us to tap into deeper levels of our own courage and strength to live our dreams even more fully than we already are. This week, meet Carrie Plank. Her passion for raising goats and producing natural soaps and face creams for her community transformed her life and the lives of her children in a way that you can't imagine. Then I'll be talking with Michael Stelmach, the founder of Broad Spectrum Health Center in Aston, Pennsylvania. Michael's passion for chemistry led him into the world of hemp and CBD, where he now formulates products to support the health and wellness for people struggling with pain and inflammation, sleep issues, and more. Michael will be sharing everything that we need to know about the world of CBD and how it works. Next, we'll spend some time with Alden and Susan Schutte. Their passion for Buffalo, New York inspired them to write a song in the late 70s that became an anthem for our hometown. Alden and Susan decided to revise the song with a new version to bring us together in these challenging times and lift the spirits of the community that they have such a passion for. But first, I'm going to share a passionate living adventure that I was lucky enough to experience on a friend's one-of-a-kind speedboat. I won't tell you how fast we went, but I will share that with my love of speed and heights, it brought a huge smile to my face. So come join me for this week's Passionate Living Adventure. Mike, what an amazing vehicle. This is gorgeous.
Thanks.
Tell me, it's one of a kind, right?
One of a kind. Not another one in the world like it.
Wow.
Yep.
Now, how many hours, you were telling me, the woman that painted this?
500 hours. Hand painted all the artwork on it.
Wow. What was her name?
Nancy Blowers.
Yep.
1997.
Wow. That's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
And how long is this?
41 foot.
41 foot for all the boat fans out there. And this is definitely your passion.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Passion and a full time job.
Wow. Yeah, I bet it is. Now, how much would a boat like this cost today to make something like this?
Around $2 million.
Wow.
To replace this boat.
Wow, it's extraordinary.
Yeah.
And tell me about the engines.
The engines are 653 cubic inch Ritchie Zools. Who's one of the top five engine builders in the world. They put out a little over 1,000 horsepower each.
It's a gorgeous boat.
Thank you.
Oh gosh, could I take a little spin in it?
Yep. Nothing like it. There's nothing like it.
In these challenging times, it's more important than ever to nourish ourselves with daily self-care. So often in life, we find ourselves racing around from work, running errands, then home to family responsibilities. And we neglect taking those quiet moments throughout the day to center ourselves. I know that when I afford myself a few extra moments in the middle of a hectic day to close my eyes and give gratitude or listen to a guided meditation, it makes all the difference. So today, I challenge you to watch a little less news, stay off social media for an extra few moments, and to sit for a full 5 minutes and simply become aware of your breath. Remember, in such moments, take a deep breath, hold that breath for a moment, and then exhale. By taking the time out of your day to do this simple exercise, you'll be more centered, more calm, and you'll enjoy your day a whole lot more. So make that commitment to the most important person on this planet, you, and take just 5 minutes to sit quietly and become aware of your breath. Now, let's meet a woman whose desire to start a farm in upstate New York introduced her to an even greater purpose in life of raising goats and sharing that love with her community by producing amazing soaps and skincare products. Carrie, this is an amazing, amazing place that you have here.
Thank you.
How did you get started doing all this?
So we're actually looking at my original homestead of 5 acres. I moved in 2001
right.
with my husband at the time. We bought this little acreage that had this was all forested on the side of the property. There's a home and then a 2-car garage. And fast forward about 5 years later, after quitting my career with the government, with the U.S. Department of Agriculture, I became pregnant with my first 2 children and decided I wanted to do like a little homesteading operation. And so I looked into goat farming. I started out with 3 animals and ended up with 10 the following year.
Wow.
Built some
That's huge growth.
Yes, yeah. Huge growth.
So Rajiv, you are here with your kids today playing with goats. I love that.
Yes, we are very fortunate to and we're very grateful to Carrie to open the farm up to let our little kids play with the goats and for us to see her production space and her, you know, her studio where she makes the soaps and the lotions. It's great.
It is great. And you're part of Leadership Buffalo?
That's right. We came here 2-3 weeks ago as a part of our site visit. We were visiting different organizations. We visited Alpine Made, and we visited the sister company here called Let's Goat Buffalo.
Right.
Very interesting company that uses goats for landscaping.
I love that.
It's a great story, and we got to meet the goats, and we got to meet Carrie and see the wonderful work that she's doing. Her story is really inspirational for someone to just start out with 3 goats and then, you know, build all of this in about 10 years. It's great.
It's pretty amazing.
It's an inspiring story. Well, and I wanted, after hearing the story, I wanted the kids to meet the goats and wanted my wife to meet Carrie.
That's wonderful. Yeah. Oh, Rajiv, thank you so much for sharing today.
No, that's all. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
This is the original goat that was born on my farm originally 11 years ago.
Wow.
So he's an old man, but he's an amazing goat. He really participates well with the program. He's a little wobbly, but he gets on that bus. Jen takes him where he needs to go with his herd.
That's great.
He does great.
I love it.
Yeah, that's Dee Dee, and then his buddy Danny. Danny's a 2-year-old goat and does really well with the program, Jen's program. So this is our store. So this is the church, the Lutheran church that was built in 1832, converted now to my soap making facility / store, little mini store, and eventually a place where we can have workshops and all kinds of services offered in the main sanctuary. That was a goal of ours in 2020, but
this is amazing.
Yeah.
Wow, what a cool space.
Yeah, so we have a skincare product line of about 6 different skincare items, and then we have about 20 different kinds of soaps. We've been trying to consolidate our efforts to the best-selling soaps and then keeping the best-selling skincare products, and we sell in stores such as Wegmans, and Whole Foods, as well as much smaller stores that are locally owned and operated by people of Western New York.
I love your soaps. That's how I met you, was going to the farmer's market and finding your soaps and your amazing skincare items there.
So this is 1,700 square feet of a basement that the church membership put in the 1960s. So originally, when the church was built, this was all that was here, was these big beam structures, and there was no basement. but the church wanted a community area to be able to service their members and have and create meals and have strawberry shortcake events and chowder events to draw in people for fundraising. So this was a huge space that I had to work with, and this is where the commercial kitchen that the church used became our soap making area and skincare making area, and then this is our packaging area, curing area for the soaps, and an office over in the corner.
Oh, Carrie, thank you so much for sharing your goats with us today.
Thanks
and
for coming out,
and your passion, and it's inspiring to see what you've done last 10 years. Thank you. I am here today with a new friend, Michael Stelmach, and Michael's passion for chemistry took him into the world of CBD and hemp, and he's using that passion to make a difference in the world of health right now, and I'd like to find out a little bit from Michael today, all of us. Michael, welcome to the show, and what is CBD? There is such a huge clamoring about CBD for this and for that. Can you tell me a little bit about it?
Sure, absolutely. So there's 118 or so chemicals extracted from the hemp plant now. Hemp is the cannabis sativa plant. And these chemicals collectively known are known as cannabinoids. And they all have different beneficial properties. CBD, we kind of know, we've all heard of that by now, and that's like our all-purpose player. It's good for three things specifically, but way more than that. But specifically, anxiety, inflammation, pain, and insomnia.
Right. That's a big one now. With everything going on, people have insomnia, myself included, more often than usual, I've noticed, with all the stress going on in the world around us right now.
It's been a crazy world this year, and people are really needing help getting to sleep. And to that end, we've created a couple products here to get people nice and cozy, get their mind right, and their body in the right position to get to sleep.
Now, Michael, how did you find yourself doing this? What drew you to hemp CBD?
Well, so that's a long path. So I started originally after college in paint research, and then went to medical research at the Cleveland Clinic. And after some time in industry, I just wasn't happy working for someone else. So I decided I'm going to work for myself and find my own fortunes. And I looked around at what was going on in the world of chemistry now, and the new gold rush was THC or CBD. And I went out to California. I started a cannabis business, a medical cannabis business out there in California. After a while there, though, I became a little disillusioned with it. The THC business was not about helping people, I found out. It was more about getting people high. So I got out of that business altogether and went into CBD to help people get well. And so through CBD and the other cannabinoids, I found ways to heal people.
That's wonderful. Wow, what a beautiful outcome for your passion for chemistry, you know, to take it into this world where you're actually helping people now. That must feel really good. Yeah.
Yeah.
So tell me a little bit, there's more than CBD. What are the other chemicals in hemp that people are utilizing for health and wellness now?
Right. So here at Broad Spectrum, we specialize in CBD, CBG, which is cannabigerol, and CBN products, which is cannabinol. Now, CBG is more specific to pain and inflammation. That's cannabigerol, and that's the initial cannabinoid that develops on the hemp plant. And if you harvest that hemp early, you're going to help end up with a whole bunch of CBG. And this is, again, beneficial for pain, inflammation, glaucoma even.
Wow, so that works even better than the CBD. The CBG,
for the pain and
inflammation aspect of things?
We're finding they actually work better together than alone.
Okay.
So right. CBD and CBG together is, by some accounts, up to 30 times more potent than CBD alone for treating your pain and inflammation.
Wow, that's amazing. Now, what is the other chemical that you mentioned? CBN, is it?
Right, yes. Yeah. CBN, cannabinol, is, again, another multiple of 30 times more potent than CBD alone for getting people to sleep. I got a product here. I'll bring it up if this is the right time. Sure. This is a product that's got CBN in it. It's got a potent herbal blend, valerian root, mugwort, skullcap, lemon balm, kava kava. But mixed in with that, we've mixed melatonin, which we all have heard gets people to sleep and helps people get in the right mindset. But then the CBN and CBD in there together with it just drive a lot of people over the edge. We've had a lot of people replace their prescription sleep medications with this all-natural product.
Wow. Now, I love that you take the other herbs and mix them in with the CBD products, because that they're all very good to support, like, you know, reducing inflammation or helping to sleep.
CBD is really beneficial, but only if it's used correctly. And so used in conjunction with these other things can help get your mind and body in the right frame for CBD to take its effect, or the CBG, CBN, whichever cannabinoid it is. And the other part of that is these would work alone without the cannabinoids. The cannabinoids are just provide that extra oomph to get you over the edge.
Right. Now, cannabinoids, our body actually has cannabinoid receptors in it, correct? I mean,
that's right.
That's one of the big things. I think proponents for CBD and hemp products are saying that if our bodies didn't want it, we wouldn't have cannabinoid receptors inside.
Right. So in response to certain scenarios and instructions from the body, you'll actually create certain cannabinoids within your body, which is why we have an endocannabinoid system. That's that series of receptors throughout the body, head, chest, all the way down your legs, arms. This is everywhere. And so when you take an oral CBD product, for example, it'll be spread throughout your body, and the benefits will be able to be felt throughout your body because we have these receptors many, many places.
Now, products like CBD, CBN, CBG, there's no THC in these, right? So there's no chance of anyone getting high. This is not a drug, correct?
That's right. Yeah, so all of our products, we use, these ones that I'm mentioning specifically, we use something called an isolate, which has been, all the THC has been chemically stripped from the raw material before it even gets into our products. So regardless, all of our products are below 0.3% THC, which is usually below a psychoactive amount. But the ones I'm speaking of specifically we use isolates for.
Okay, so there's no THC in those at all.
Correct. They're non-psychoactive, and you're not going to also you don't have to worry about failing a drug test. So if you get drug tests for work, your job interviews, whatever, the THC is not in there, so it won't show up.
Thank you, Michael, so much for being here today. I really appreciate it. And I appreciate our friend Barry up there in Northern Cal for connecting us.
Thank you, Barry.
Barry didn't have to evacuate his farm. He was getting really close. He had all of his animals there. I talked to him yesterday, and it's always so funny talking to him because you can hear the sheep baaing. There's a llama in the background, some horses. I think they were all happy not to evacuate as well.
It was scary, some of those photos he was sending me.
Yeah. Well, we send blessings to all of our friends out there in California. And thank you, Michael, so much for joining me today. I really appreciate
it. This has been a blast. Thank you so much. And if you ever want to do this again, please let me know.
Great. Thank you.
It's Lucy from the Healthy Communities 2030 team. Are you looking to get healthier? Are you looking to affect the health of a loved one?
We want to help you, whether it's mental health, physical exercise, or falls prevention. We are here to support your health.
If you want to learn more, give us a call at 716-851-4052 or check out our website, creatinghealthycommunities.org.
Formerly the Wellness Institute of Greater Buffalo, a Phil Habistro production.
I'm here today with two bright, talented spirits who have an amazing project that they're doing here in Western New York with Alden and Susan Schutte. And welcome to the show.
Well, thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Thanks for being on. So this amazing project that you're doing, I love that it is your passion. You've taken your skills of all of the years that you've worked in an ad agency, a successful right. ad agency for over 30 years, and you're taking those skills and you're using them to lift your community, which is such a beautiful gift to Western New York. Now, can you tell me a little bit about this project that you're doing?
Well, I think it's fascinating because it sort of matches up with your show and the title, right?
Right.
This all started, three, 4 months ago. In 1981, Susan and I put together a campaign in the area called We're Talking Proud. And now with this COVID-19 crisis going on, we felt that there was so much negative news out there that it was time for something to happen that would uplift the community, to lift the spirits, and tell people that we really applaud the efforts that all of the Western New Yorkers have done to try to deal with this difficulty we all face. Talking one night, we decided that maybe the best way to do that is to take a rebirth of the We're Talking Proud campaign and build it into a campaign called Buffalo Proud. And the one thing that the campaign did in 1981 is it really talked about the pride of the community and how much we all love it here.
Buffalo Proud spirit, talking proud, talking proud, listen up. Can you hear it? Talking proud, talking proud, talking proud, talking proud.
And that was really sort of the genesis of the campaign, the new one, Buffalo Proud, is to talk about the pride that the community has. And my feeling is that Buffalo Proud is all about us. It's our statement, our uniqueness. There are other campaigns out there that have been borrowed from other cities, but Buffalo Proud is us. It's what we're all about.
That's beautiful. And we had talked about how I was doing the same thing, that Passionate Living was a project that I did years ago to lift people to live their passions. And this time just seemed like the perfect one to relaunch it, to lift people.
And what's different about Buffalo Proud from We're Talking Proud is this campaign has a philanthropic component to it.
Yeah.
Because we started to really understand the needs of the community, and one of the needs that has gone unmet, there are several of course, was the Buffalo Zoo. The animals needed to be fed and cared for regardless of whether there was a revenue stream or not. So that we integrated that into the campaign.
So the funds from the Buffalo Proud campaign go into support projects like the Buffalo Zoo.
Right, a portion of the sales of the T-shirts that, and now what we're going to bring out is a Buffalo Proud mask. The portion of that will go to the zoo.
And I saw you had the Buffalo Proud signs too for the front lawns.
Yeah.
Yes.
I love that. Where can people get this? These products.
Well, if they go to the website that we have, bfloproud.com, you can get all the information you need. It talks about the campaign, how it evolved, why we developed it, and gives the access to the companies that are producing and delivering those products.
Now, Alden and Susan, you've been a part of this community for as long as I can remember.
For sure.
And you had an ad agency for many
years. Correct, we did.
It was very well
30-some years.
30-some, just a few years.
Yeah, just a few, yeah.
Yes, and that's where you got your skills to take a project like this and put it out to the community and use your skills to lift.
Right. Well, it worked for us this year because, like everybody else, we sort of got stuck with the COVID-19 and we couldn't get back to Florida in March.
Right.
So we had some time, and you know, as we were talking over the dinner table one night, the idea of resurrecting We're Talking Proud came about, and it was great. It kept us busy, busy for a number of months putting it together.
That's wonderful. Yeah. Well, on behalf of everyone in this community, I want to thank you for this wonderful project you're doing.
Well, it's a pleasure, and you know, it's gaining some momentum, and we hope it just keeps going. And we have some other products out there that, before too long, hopefully it'll be out on the market too. So it's been fun. So we appreciate the opportunity to chat with you about it and collaborate on making Buffalo feel better about itself.
Thank you so much.
Make everybody Buffalo proud.
Make everybody Buffalo proud. I love that. Thank you. I want to thank Susan and Alden for the amazing work that they do in their community. If you'd like to support their efforts in this campaign, make sure to check out this website where you can get a cool shirt like the one that I'm wearing, along with face masks and much more. Thanks to both of you for your amazing work and for how you make this world a better place.
Our town has got the spirit standing up and Buffalo proud. It's a new day and we'll live it, rising up and winning now. We've always met our challenges with strength and discipline, 'cause we care about our families, our neighbors and our friends. Our town has got the spirit standing up, Buffalo proud.
Before we leave today, I'd like to share another simple technique for centering during these challenging times. This is called earthing. And it's as simple as taking off your shoes and walking barefoot on the earth. Just to be clear, you want to stand on dirt or grass versus concrete, floors, asphalt, or anything like that. You see, your body has an electrical current running through it. And as the Journal of Environmental and Public Health states, it's an established, though not widely appreciated fact, that the Earth's surface possesses a limitless and continuously renewed supply of free or mobile electrons. Your body is naturally able to absorb these electron charges from the earth, since your skin acts like a conductor. Your feet, specifically certain points on the balls of your feet, are believed to be especially good at receiving the earth's electricity. But because of our modern way of living, for example, always wearing shoes and being on floors inside in homes and offices that are several floors up, we're losing touch with the earth's natural electrical force. The idea is that by being in touch with the planet, the electrical force coming off of the earth is able to help lower inflammation and fight free radicals. In fact, the term earthing has even earned a patent as a natural method for reducing disease causing inflammation. Thank you to all of our amazing guests, to our generous sponsors, WBBZ-TV, our true hometown station, and to Healthy Communities 2030 for all the amazing work that they do in the world. And a very special thanks to you for joining me on this exciting adventure of passionate living. View Passionate Living each week on WBBZ-TV, Tuesday and Thursday evenings at 8 p.m. and Sundays at 11 a.m. Plus, you can view former Passionate Living shows on our YouTube channel at passionateliving.tv or on our website at passionateliving.com. Shows are posted online a week after their television premiere. Thanks for watching, and remember, until next week, live passionately.